Now, historically, as I said, these five very important works, they relate to Hatha Yoga. And if we look to the evolution of Hatha Yoga, we cannot fix exact date. This has been the weakness of our authors. They never mention neither the name nor the date. But we have a book of Tantra, which is called Guhya Samaj Tantra, written by a king. His name was Asanga, A-S-A-N-G. In this book, he mentions Yadana Siddhyate Bodhi Hatha Yoging Sadhaye. His period is 3rd century AD. So we can definitely say when he is recommending, because you know the Buddhism and Yoga, they were very close, and he advises that if you don't succeed through the Buddhist means to achieve the Nirvana, resort to Hatha Yoga. Yadana Siddhyate Bodhi, if you don't succeed by practicing the Buddhist technique, Hatha Yoga in Sadhe, we are free to practice Hatha Yoga. So it seems in 3rd century AD, the Hatha Yoga was practiced. But we do not know, because in Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, few postures, sculpture is also found. We cannot put the date nor be bothered that when it started, who started it. This is this attitude we don't have. We are concerned what it says, what is to be practiced, how to be practiced, why to be practiced. So, as you know, progressively we come. If you see the evolution of Hatha Yoga, in different texts we find that different steps are being described. For example, if you refer to Hatha Pradipika, it prescribes only the 4 steps. Asanam, Kumbhakam, Chitram. Asan, Kumbhak means pranayama. Mudrakhyam karanam tatha, mudras. Atha nadan sannan abhyasan kramo hata. This is the sequence to be followed according to Hatha Pradipika. But if you go to Gorakhnath, 10th century, he recommends 6 steps. Asanam prana samrodha, pranayama. Pratyaharasya dharana dhyanam samadhiretani yogangani vadanti shat. He says there are 6 steps to be followed. You come to Girand Sahita. It advises 7 steps. It includes the cleansing process, kriyas also. But Shiva Sahita does not limit into the steps. It is free from them. When we start it, you will find it is a combination practically of many views, many philosophical aspect of thought. It does not limit itself to one aspect. Now, about the origin of Shiva Sahita, we conclude that, as it is said, Hatha Yoga is a byproduct of Tantra. It seems that more influence of Tantra also is seen in certain practices of which is described in Shivsena. We do not know the author, because its very name, whosoever has written, has ascribed this to Lord Shiva. It is just like the discussion between Shiva and his wife. She asks the question and Shiva replies it. Therefore, neither we can put the date nor we can say who was the author. But one thing very beautiful which will be seen here is that there is no criticism of any philosophy.